I would like to make use of this opportunity to extend on behalf of the Council of Ministers, but also on behalf of my person and my family, my wife, Gabrielle, our deepest sympathy to Grace Marlin and her family, her children, and to former Commissioner, Island Council member, and Member of Parliament, Roy Marlin, and his family, our deepest sympathy on the passing, the sudden passing, actually, of husband, brother, son, Jose Marlin, a former president of the St. Martin Taxi Drivers Association. Jose was well known in the community as a very friendly, caring, loving person. We know his sudden passing has caught many off guard, particularly the immediate family. And we pray that the good Lord looks over them in the coming days, and our prayers and thoughts are with them. I promised the Minister of Education I would be even shorter. There's one item that I have to address today, and that is that the committee to advise on the electoral reform based on the national decree that was signed, now having the elections take place on the 26th of September, that committee that is referred to in that national decree will be signed off. The committee will be established today by ministerial decree. It will be made up of the following persons: Mr. Julian Lamoni, legal advisor to the Prime Minister, is a member and chairman of the committee, former Lieutenant Governor and constitutional advisor, or advisor rather, to several parliamentary delegations. Attorney Ralph Richardson will be a member also and deputy chair of the committee. Mr. Jules De Vries, the head of legal affairs, will be the third member of the committee. And Mr. Hensley Plantain, the secretary general of the Ministry of General Affairs, will be the secretary to the committee. Within 2 weeks of today, I think that's January 6th, the committee will present its working plan, and part of that plan will include the date that they will submit their results to the minister, and the date of their final advice, and their final advice should be submitted no later than March 15th, 2016. And the ministerial decree will expire on the 31st of October, 2016.
Yesterday, I finally presented the budget to the Council of Ministers, and a meeting has been scheduled for tomorrow morning, 9:30, to go through the broad budget and to get the budget approved. It pleases me to share with you that the budget is a balanced budget for the year 2016. It took some acrobatic moves, but don't remember, a budget is a projection that steps will have to be taken to make certain that we follow the path that the budget has outlined and not depart from it. A budget is a road that has a starting point and a destination. On that road, of course, you can meet boulders that have fallen on the road that you'll have to go around, or you might find trees that fell on the road that disturbs your path. But at the end, you have to make sure that every time you find such an obstacle, that you go around it and get back on path in order for you to reach your destination at the end of the year. And that has been the problem in the past, that we prepare budgets and then don't stick to the budget. And that's the way we end up with the humongous amount of debt that we face today. We have to make a start to make a dent in that mountain of debt that we built up. We cannot continue as business as usual. So I intend to put a program in place that will be monitoring the budgets of the various ministries on a regular basis to see if anywhere they have run into a boulder that disturbs the path that has been chosen, and to take steps to make certain that they get back on the path as soon as possible, so that at the end of the road, they could be reaching their destination.
Makes people suddenly appear.
Really?
Uh-huh, you're here.
It makes people suddenly appear.
At the right time.
Santa! Festive Feast from KFC. The taste that brings everyone together. So good.
I can understand why you're parking so carefully. Of course, when you can get 80% discount on your B-Sure car insurance. But that's overdoing it, Bob.
Are you B-Sure? B-Sure.
Yeah. Oh my, what an inventory list, and so unnecessary. But wait, your home contents are all insured by BeSure. That means that you determine the amount you want to insure. No inventory list, no hassle.
Are you BeSure? BeSure.
Joy awakening at your feet, we fall.
funny, man. I feel like I'm getting a pain in my chest.
I got this.
You sure?
Yes, yes. It's you 30 sure? breaths and 2 compressions. Give her air.
Oh, Monique, look, she wake
no, no, Fala. It is not 30 breaths and 2 compressions. It is 30 compressions and 2 breaths. CPR can be done in 3 simple steps. Step 1, check and call. Step 2, press down or pump. Step 3, blow.
I got it now. It's 30 compressions and 2 breaths.
Yes.
C-A-B.
GEBE has been faithfully serving the communities of St. Martin, powering your home and our economy. Come rain or shine, our qualified team of professionals are working hard 24 hours a day to provide you and your family with safe, reliable electricity and water. We use the latest technologies and test our products daily to maintain the highest international standards. Our friendly staff is always there to assist you, whether in person, over the phone, or online. We are committed to constantly improving our products and services, making them more efficient, effective, and environmentally friendly to serve you better today and our next generation of clients tomorrow. GEBE, powering a brighter future.
Our friend Mega Wadi is here with tips to save you energy. 1. Turn your airco temperature up. 2. Use a ceiling fan instead. 3. Buy energy-saving products. Save some green with NVGEBE.
Need a loan that's quick and easy.
Island Finance.
Up to 50,000 guineas really easy.
Island Finance.
For education, yes. A renovation.
That's no problem. Yes, it's true.
That's not all. They're quick and friendly too.
Island Finance.
Appliances, vacations, even fix your car. You can depend on Island Finance.
A couple of immigration officers who had to clear all these tourists coming in left because they had to go to a meeting. That is a situation that's quite unfortunate. Quite unfortunate because it does not help the situation that we're in. It aggravates it. We have to expand this economy. We have to get more tourists in. We need to increase the revenues that we earn annually. And we can only do that by being better at the only product, the pillar of our economy, and that is tourism. Of course, this situation that we're in creates frustration, which I understand. Creates frustration for everyone. But that frustration is not going to be helped by making matters worse than they are. It takes cooperation, patience. You don't cut off your nose to spite your face. Now, about 2.5 weeks ago to 3 weeks, I met with the union of the police organization. They had an agenda, a long list of items that go back 6 years. And we went through each one of those items. And then I had opportunity to explain to them what the financial situation of the country is and to let them know that I'm working on the budget for 2016 and I need an opportunity to address all of the issues. Most of them were not mentioned in detail. Lo and behold, that some of the issues regarding promotions, regarding payments, were already approved. And this information I only found out or got to know yesterday. We're already approved. The paperwork relative to all of these payments seem to have disappeared. And this is a problem throughout government, that documents keep mysteriously disappearing and lends to dissatisfaction, lends to confusion. A sort of a manhunt was started to find where these documents were, to be able to execute them because they were already approved. That was not an easy task for my cabinet at the Ministry of Justice, but eventually they were found. Some were half completed. In fact, it was only yesterday afternoon at 5 o'clock that these documents landed on my desk, and when I looked at them, they had negative advices from the various departments that related to there are no funds. That's the situation that I was confronted with, that I was trying to get to the bottom of, and finally yesterday afternoon, 5 o'clock, we got to the bottom of it. At any rate, some have been managed to complete, some I've been able to get done, and some I had to hold until January. If a minister, according to the articles in our criminal code, signs any document obligating the government to pay any money for which he knows there are no funds, it is punishable by law with a jail imprisonment of maximum three years. That law is there for a reason. It's there so that you're forced to stick to your budget and not amount $183 million in debt that you have difficulties to pay.
What's your idea of holiday happiness? Watching the kids open presents. Cooking in our new kitchen. The look on his face. Add to your holiday happiness with a loan from Scotiabank and you could win a trip for two to Miami and other great prizes. Visit your Scotiabank branch today and talk to a representative about getting your loan. Contest ends January 15th. Conditions apply. Scotiabank. Discover what's possible.
Praises ring to the newborn King, peace on earth. here with us, joy awakening, at your feet we fall.
Everything is perfect and you would be great for the job. But I see here that there's a 2-year gap in your resume. What did you do?
I was hospitalized for mental illness.
Oh, mental illness?
I've undergone treatment and I have a wonderful family that supports me.
Well, that is good news.
No, it's fine. I'm recovered.
We'll contact you, okay?
For a better understanding of mental health and what you can do to stop mental health stigma, please go to the Mental Health Foundation's website at www.mhf-sxm.com.
Present situation of these companies and departments. We identified, among others, problem areas and discussed ways to improve where necessary and move forward where there are stagnation. My modus operandi is to first identify and prioritize those matters that require immediate attention. The ministry has the aim to be the primary institute for delivering policy for stimulation and facilitating of sustainable economic development and to become the effective facilitator of a growing, vibrant economy. In order for the Ministry of TIAT to achieve its objective, our focus will be on income generating, to streamline our processes, and build the capacity of our personnel to be able to provide efficient and effective services. As was stated in my previous press statement, my first priority is the establishment of the St. Martin Tourist Authority. The establishment of the STA is critical, and as such, it has my urgent attention. Contrary to what was stated in the media, I have not shelved the STA, but is moving forward with the foundation, and we have already started the process to advertise to fill the position of the director, who will be interim director, and be the one responsible for getting the STA up and running. I will keep the public and the media abreast of all the developments with the establishment of the STA, which will be taking place sooner rather than later. Secondly, I was honored to be present to have presented the Blue Flag Eco Label Award to 2 honorees, mainly the Ile de Sol Yacht Club and the Divi Little Bay Beach Resort. Once again, congratulations to both these entities for receiving this award, which recognizes their effort and achievement in protecting our beautiful beaches and the environment in general. This award is given to beaches, marinas, and boat yards that comply with very strict requirements. Both entities successfully faced the challenges and were able to maintain the environmental, educational, safety, and related criteria for the 2nd consecutive years. Congratulations again to both of these entities. I want to encourage other properties and organizations to be vigilant in protecting our environment so that we can continue to have our beautiful beaches. These awards are also excellent marketing tools as it identify St. Martin as a destination that cares about and protecting and preserving our beautiful, clean, and safe beaches for our residents and guests. As you are aware, I also did the inauguration of the new largest model, Crane 6, and the container vessel, Marseille. I refer to this again briefly because I want to highlight the fact that the harbor continues to improve its services by investing in human resources, which most recently, the CEO of the port, Mr. Mingo, signed a human resource training agreement with the University of St. Martin under the banner, the 2016 Core Values for Program of Excellence, as well as the investment in the equipment, such as the new Gutwell Model Crane 6. The world around us is getting smaller, and competition is fierce. Port St. Martin is number one in the Caribbean. In order for them to maintain their status, they need to keep investing in the human resources in order to continue on the track that has been built in making Port St. Martin the leading port in the Caribbean. I also recently had a presentation about Port St. Martin's strategic business plan and best approaches with respect to moving forward. I would like to express my appreciation of all those persons who directly or indirectly make a positive contribution to keep our competitive edge as we move on to the new year ahead and beyond.